Would you like to take the guesswork out of knowing when to water your plants? Self-watering pots or self-watering planters are the ultimate solution, whether you're growing your plants in soil or whether you're growing your plants in semi-hydroponics like Leca. But they can be pretty expensive. I will show you how you can make your very own beautiful self-watering planter with a water indicator for less than $10. Hello, it's Nora, the Leca Queen, helping you grow thriving plants. Many plant parents growing their plants in soil struggle with knowing when to water their plants. And if you're growing your plants in semi-hydroponics like Leca, finding self-watering pots that can contain the nutrient solution, provide airflow, can be problematic without resorting to very expensive options. Stick around to the end because I'm going to show you how I get my plants to look beautiful in gorgeous pots, making them look like gorgeous works of art without the expensive price tag. To make the pots, I'm going to need nursery pots. I use clear ones because I like to use clear ones, and clear ones are very readily available for me. You do not need to use clear pots. You can use any pots that you have at your disposal, a black one, anything, it doesn't really matter. I also add additional ventilation to my pots, all these holes in there, because I grow my plants in semi-hydroponics, so it works well for that. But you don't need to have these holes, especially if you're growing your plants in soil. You also need an outer cash pot. This is what I'm calling a cash pot. A cash pot does not have a hole at the base, as you can see. It can be made of plastic, it can be made of ceramics, but if it's made of ceramic, it needs to have a glaze inside so that it's able to take to hold on to that water or nutrient solution. We're gonna need a microfiber cloth. The microfiber cloth is what we're going to use to draw the water from the reservoir into the plants, or either into your soil or into your Leca or whatever medium you're using. You don't have to use a microfiber cloth. You can use kind of microfiber string or anything like that. People use all sorts of things for self-watering pots, but microfiber cloths have got a very good reputation for this, so that's what I'm going to be using today. And of course, we're going to need some water level indicators. You can make your own. These are pretty easy to make with some PVC piping and, you know, sponge or whatever, but I didn't want to go that way, largely because I want my pots to look nice, which is the whole point. And these are largely because I want my pots to look nice, and these are relatively cheap. So, you know, I figured I might as well grab those, and it works just fine. You're gonna need a ruler, something to write with, a pair of scissors, and we're also going to need some extra nursery pots. And I'll tell you why we need this in a second. So step one, I'm gonna cut my microfiber cloth into thin strips. So just grab my scissors. And I don't need them to be very thick, but depending on the size of pot that you've got, you can make this as thick as you need it to be. Got my microfiber cloth strips there. Step two, we're going to put the nursery pot into the cash pot that we want that plant to sit in. Then you're going to grab your ruler and you're going to measure the distance between the top of the nursery pot and the top of the cash pot. You're going to grab your ruler, measure that distance, and that for me is about 1.8 centimeters. And the importance of this distance is this is how high we want our riser to sit in the pot, because that's going to bring our nursery pot up to there, right at the top. So we will do that with our other pot as well. Pot, you can actually get your cash pot to be a bit deeper if you want to have a deeper reservoir. So this particular one has got a depth of about 3 centimeters. So this pot is going to have a bigger cash, a bigger nutrient store in this one than this one, because this one is only 1.8. But then again, it's wider. So maybe the volume's the same. I don't know, you know. Anyway, this is now where we grab our nursery pot that we're going to use to make the risers. So the risers are what's going to keep the pot at the top. What you can do is you can cut this base off if you want, or you can keep it on. It doesn't really matter. So I grab my ruler. I'm just marking where 3 centimeters is there. I'm marking where 3 centimeters is, and I do that throughout. Normally, I would use a rubber band. Actually, just put a rubber band there and that acts as my guide. But of course, in true life fashion, now that I'm actually making this video, my rubber bands are lost. But there we go. So once you've made those marks, it's easy to know where you need to cut. So that is 3 centimeters and that is going to be my riser. So I grab my scissors and you use that to cut, but I like to use my knife and I'm very, very careful while I'm doing this. And I highly encourage you to be careful if you are. And my knife just acts as a way for me to start cutting and I've got my way into my pot. So there I go. Perfect. So that is going to be my riser. But remember, you can cut off that base if you want. As long as you've got that 3 centimeters, that's all that matters. This is waist. So I'll grab my pot, I'll put that in there, and that is how my plant will sit. So my pot sits there and it's now rising. I didn't cut it straight enough. I'll do that. There we go. That is how my pot sits. And that is my self-watering planter. So, you know, I don't know if I did a very good job, but you can be really precise about this and make that pot absolutely flush to the line. Step 3 is you want to make a hole inside the nursery pot. That hole over there, and that's the hole through which you're going to have your self-watering device go through. Like that. You can use a pair of scissors to make that hole. You can also use your soldering iron, but just make something large enough to have that self-watering device go through like that. If you don't want to make your hole, depending on how wide your cash pot is, you can actually attach your water indicator to the side of the pot and that sits at the bottom like that. My pots aren't that wide, so it makes it a little bit fiddly to squeeze everything in there together with the riser. So I found it easier to just put it in with the pot. The next step is you grab your microfiber cloth and thread it through the holes in your nursery pot. I'll just put that through there and put that in to come out on the other side. Hang on, that other side. Put that through there. Depending on the length of your microfiber cloth, you could make a little bit of a knot just to make sure it doesn't slip out. It's not necessary. And to be honest, it might be a bit annoying when you're trying to take it out. You might have to cut off the whole thing, but that's something you can do. That's an option if you choose to follow it. There you go. So that is your microfiber cloth in there. And again, depending on what you're doing with your plant, I know lots of people who grow their plants in soil have the microfiber cloth going all the way to the top. So if that's what you're going to do, you might want to make sure that the length of your microfiber cloth is going to accommodate that. I don't need to do that, so that is not really a big problem for me. Oops, that is a bit fiddly. I'm going to use my scissors to thread that through. So I've got my 2 pots linked with my microfiber cloth in there. If you're finding value from this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. So I've got a riser that I made earlier for my 14 centimeter pot. That's my pot that sits right at the top. That's gorgeous. This is my riser that I made earlier for my pot over here. I put it in there and that's fantastic. I'm gonna do a breakdown for you cost-wise what this all means. A microfiber cloth for me in Australian dollars costs 50 cents and I could cut this into about 10 or more strips, which gives me about 5 cents a strip. This 10 centimeter pot costs me about 72 Australian cents. The water indicator costs me $4.70, and that's only because I'm actually buying one item. If you bought these wholesale, you could probably get them a heck of a lot cheaper. The 14 centimeter pot costs me $1, an Australian dollar. And indicator for my 14 centimeter pot, which is a 22 centimeter indicator, costs me $5. These are IKEA mascot pots. This is the 12 centimeter one that costs me $4. This is the 15 centimeter one that costs me $5. So all in all, the most expensive parts of these self-watering pots are the cash pots and the water indicator. So to make a fully functional 10 centimeter cash pot with a water indicator is costing me $6.63. And to make a 14 centimeter self-watering cash pot with a self-watering indicator is costing me $12.51. I'm going to show you how I pot up my philodendron pink princess into this 14 centimeter self-watering device. Grab my self-watering device. I open that up just to make it easier to get that in there, and I'll close it like so. So I make sure that's closed. My water indicator is now held within my nursery pot. Lift up my microfiber cloth a little bit and put some Leca in the pot. So just about a third of the way up, filled with Leca. And then I put my plant in and fill that pot up with Leca. Microfiber cloth there, my self-water indicator there. Grab my pot with the riser in it. Make sure the riser is where I need it to be. That's my philodendron pink princess potted up in its self-watering pot with a water level indicator. Now my level indicator is slightly high. It's up because of all the water that's come from the Leca and is sitting a little bit in the reservoir. That probably won't happen with you, but that's why that's happened. So I'm now going to fill up my reservoir and let's watch what's happening with that dial. There we go. That's now telling me that my reservoir is at its maximum and my plant is well watered. Now that is not bad for less than $10, don't you think? So you can see that's a very simple way of getting the self-watering pot look at a very, very economical price. However, if you're looking for something a little bit better than that IKEA pot, I got you covered, because sometimes you just want your pretty baby to look extra pretty. A gorgeous ceramic pot is probably what you need. Now I have these fantastic ceramic pots. This one is for my 10 centimeter pot and that sits in there. And this one is for my 14 centimeter pot. It's a riser there. That'll sit in the pot and the nursery pot will sit on top, and that creates a reservoir in there. So if you're looking for something that's a bit more top-notch than the IKEA one, I certainly recommend that you go out and find some ceramic pots that will do it. Properly made ceramic pots, and I'm not saying IKEA ones aren't properly made, I don't know, but this one is very thick. I got these little IKEA ones yesterday, and I'm telling you, I think between the trip in the car, coming home, and my kids, this one's already got a chip. Not liking that. It'll still work fine because the crack is right at the top. My reservoir is going to be fine, but I now have to make sure that I've got my pot turned the other way at all times so no one can see that chip. But these babies are not doing any such thing. Yes, it will cost a little bit more, but it's the look that you're going for, isn't it? I've also got this one here. This is my begonia white ice, and oh my goodness, look at her living in that pot. I did the same thing with this plant. She's got her little water indicator there and she is loving it in this gorgeous, gorgeous ceramic pot from Angus and Celeste. There's a lot of scope for creativity when you're taking care of plants, and it doesn't have to be expensive and it can be a lot of fun. Watch this next video where I show you how I made a moss wall for my syngonium plants. I'll see you there.